Good morning, Boker Tov, Shavua Tov, and Chodesh Tov to everybody. I hope you all had a good Shabbat. Ezrat Hashem, this week we will celebrate the holiday of Shavuot, but before we get to the halachot, we're going to hopefully finish today the halachot of Basar B'Chalav. And the last topic that I would like to cover is called Nat Bar Nat, Noten Ta'am, Bar Noten Ta'am, Dehetera. Let me explain what I mean. Let's say that a person has cooked for many times meat into a pot. The pot is obviously a meat pot. Now he has cooked meat 2 hours ago. And then right now he decides that he wants to use this pot to cook rice or to cook pasta. So we're going to say that the pasta and the rice are going to absorb the taste that is inside the pot. That is a meat taste, even though the pot is completely clean. The question, however, is, are you allowed to eat the rice and the pasta with cheese, actual cheese on it? So it's a big machloket between the Shulchan Aruch and the Rama. Sefaradim who follow the Shulchan Aruch say that it's allowed to do it. It's called noten ta'am bar noten ta'am dehetera, which means that the ta'am of the from the pot went into the pasta or the rice, and then that ta'am is going with the cheese. In other words, it's not a direct ta'am. It's not like you cook the pasta directly with meat. You only cook the pasta in a meat pot. So the meat gave the ta'am to the pot, and then the ta'am was rejected from the pot onto the pasta. So therefore, you are allowed to eat it directly with cheese. This would not be allowed, even according to Shulchan Aruch, if you would, let's say, cook those pasta into an isur pot. Let's say that we cooked in this pot something that is asur be'achila, something that has blood or has chelev or anything that is not allowed, or terefa. So in this situation, even though it's noten ta'am bar noten ta'am, which means that the isur gave ta'am to the pot and now the pot is giving the ta'am to the pasta that I'm cooking inside, it's called noten ta'am bar noten ta'am de isura, and I'm not allowed to have those pasta. If there is no shishim, I'm not allowed to have the pasta. Now, like I said earlier, if it happened with meat and dairy, we are allowed. Whichever way you go, if it was pasta cooked in the dairy pot or pasta cooked in the meat pot, you are allowed, whichever case, to eat those pasta together with cheese. But the chidush is, according to Chacham Ovad Yosef, even though you had in mind from the beginning to cook the pasta in the meat pot and to eat them with dairy, it's also allowed. It's called noten ta'am ba noten ta'am mutar afilu lecha techila, even in the first place. Not only that, the halakha also allows to eat those pasta with cheese, even if they were cooked together with something else in the pot that had the taste of meat. Let's say, for example, that we had some kind of ingredient that was cooked previously together with meat and took a little bit of the ta'am of the meat inside. But it's not a meat itself. It's just something that had the meat taste. And then I cook this ingredient together with the pasta. So the pasta absorbed the taste that is inside this ingredient of meat. Since it's not direct, it's also indirect, noten ta'am ba noten ta'am, because the ingredient received the ta'am from the meat. And then it gives the ta'am to the pasta. I am allowed to eat the pasta together with cheese. This is what we call noten ta'am ba noten ta'am dehetera. And the halakha, according to Sefaradim, is that it's mutar. So on this, we're going to finish the halakhot of Basar B'Chalav, and Me'ezrat Hashem, from now on, we'll talk about the halakhot of Shavuot. I wish you all a great day and an amazing week.